Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate. And my shirt today is from Public Space, which is like a vaporwave store that I've worn tons of stuff from before. And it is the MTV logo, but represented as MP3. Now, for like any of you viewers who are under the age of 25, MTV is a cable network, which used to play music videos in like the 80s and then gave us reality TV as we know it in the 90s. And MP3s are what we listened to before Spotify. So that's what that is. Also, for anybody who listens to my podcast, who I promised that my new gaming chair, Herman Miller chair, would be set up, my office is still a mess. My gaming chair is not set up, so you need to bully me on Twitter. All right, enough of all that. Let's get into this week's latest developer news. So first up, huge, huge, huge news. The Microsoft Surface Duo has officially been announced and is out for pre-order. So it will be up, available for them to sale next month. And if you don't remember, if you're not familiar, the Surface Duo is a really great dual screen phone device that is different than some of the other dual screen phones in that it's more like a notebook and that it kind of, you know, opens up and you have two kind of distinct sides. You can move applications back and forth. It runs Android. Yes, this is a Microsoft Surface device that is running Android. And it's really exciting. I haven't been able to play with one personally yet, but I'm really hoping to. Panos, maybe send me one. Anyway, I've got links in the show notes in the description down below on information if you are interested in building apps for this, on what you need to do if you're an Android dev. All of your applications are going to work automatically, but if you want to add special features and take advantage of some of these new dual screen functionalities, we've got some great emulators and some great tutorials and code samples and other stuff. And so I've got links to all of that information in the show notes in the description, as well as more info on the device. So let me know in the comments what you think about the Surface Duo, and convince me, like help me like get over that hump to spend more money and buy one, pre-order one. Okay, next up, Visual Studio 1.48 is available now. This is the July 2020 release, and this is a big one. This is one you definitely want to download. It includes a lot of new features, including Setting Sync to stable, which now means that Setting Sync is now available for preview in the stable release. So it's still in preview. You still need to enable it, but this is a feature, if you're not familiar, that'll basically keep all of your extensions and other settings in sync across machines and across devices, which is really, really great. So this is now in the stable version. It was previously only in insiders. Additionally, there is an updated extensions view menu. And so this is simplified and it has some more filtering options. There's also a new Git view submenu, which is basically been kind of refactored and makes things a little bit easier to understand and view from within the source control menu. And there is updated in-browser debugging. So you can basically debug in the browser without having to launch a configuration, which is really great. You can also publish things directly to a public repository. And there are some updates around the notebooks interface that we talked about last episode. So I've got more details about everything I just mentioned in the show notes in the description, and you can download Visual Studio code there as well. And next up, in the same kind of vein with Visual Studio Code, is that the latest version of the Python for Visual Studio Code extension for August 2020 has now been released. And this has some really cool new features and is building off of stuff that's been coming in the last few months. So check that out in the show notes and the description. And in the Visual Studio space, Visual Studio Code space, Java on Visual Studio Code has been given an update. And the big thing here is that they have a new getting started experience. And so if you're new to wanting to use Java and Visual Studio Code, either to either of them or using it together, there's a new startup experience that makes it even better. There's also now a project view that will help you kind of have a better frame of reference for what you're working on. So I've got links to those two extensions in the show notes and the description down below. And I did want to actually mention, give a shout out to Tech Tim, who was actually an intern with Microsoft this summer. He has a Tech with Tim YouTube channel, and he has created a great YouTube video about using Python in Visual Studio Code and the best extensions and settings and stuff that you need to get started. So thank you, Tim, for making that video, and be sure to check out his channel and subscribe to it. So really good stuff. All right, next up, speaking of videos and learning things, we just published this week a great new Azure SQL for Beginners series on YouTube and on Channel 9. And so this is, we've got a playlist that I'll have linked to in the show notes in the description, where you can basically, from a beginning standpoint, start your journey on understanding Azure SQL. So if this is something that you're interested in and you don't have a lot of background on this sort of thing, this is the perfect series for you. The modules are super quick. You know, each of us is about 5 minutes. Really good stuff. So I've got links to that down below too. Next up, everyone's favorite developer, Scott Hanselman, has a really great blog post, which is actually kind of an update to a previous blog post about the easy way to SSH into Bash and WSL2 in Windows 10 using an external machine. So that's actually really great. This is something that I've wanted to do and had done a variant of the harder version that Scott had published a couple of weeks ago, but this new way, totally mind-changing, mind-blowing. So be sure to check that out if you are interested in doing that, because it's super cool. Right. Next up, I also want to mention, speaking of Scott Hanselman, he has released a great video called What is .NET, where he explains C# and F# and .NET Core and all the other variations. And I know that if you kind of live in like the .NET kind of ecosystem bubble, you know what all these things are. But if you're new to this, it can get kind of confusing. And even for people who might have been in the space for a while, but you haven't kept up with everything, it can be a little bit intimidating. So it's a great video from Scott. Also subscribe to his YouTube channel. All right, next up, I want to give a shout out to the TypeScript team. First of all, there is a release candidate for TypeScript 4.0, so we'll be talking about that in the future. But also, they just launched a brand new website, and it looks really, really good. So TypeScript.org is updated and looks really fresh. And so if you are not familiar with TypeScript, it's a superset of JavaScript. It's a really great language. And I've got links to the new websites and more information in the show notes and the description. On Channel 9 this week, we've got lots of really good content. First, over on Visual Studio Toolbox, we talk about source generators in C#. And then over on the IoT show, Olivier talks about building safer, more secure workplaces with IoT during the pandemic. That's always an important topic. And over on DevOps Lab, Abel talks about what's new in Terraform Azure RM 2.0 provider. And so if you're not familiar, Terraform is kind of an infrastructure as code service that lets you build templates using kind of a templating language to automate a lot of your processes. It's really cool stuff. So I've got links to all three of those videos in the show notes in the description. And now it is time for my pick of the week. All right, so technically this anniversary is gonna hit on the 24th of August, but because we will probably not have an episode out that week, I had to go ahead and mention this now. Windows 95 is 25. Okay, I feel really old because I was like 12 when it came out, so now you know how old I am. I think that most of us would agree that this is probably one of, if not the most important software operating system releases of all time. It was my first love. You know, everybody has their first. My first was Windows 95, and I just had to kind of take a moment to just kind of wax on about how much I love Windows 95, how much it changed the world. And I want to actually hear your thoughts as well. Did you wait in line? Is this something that you learned about when you were older and you saw some of the YouTube videos, like with the Friends cast, learning about it? That's a real thing. Is this something that you've played with on emulators? Are you, like me, a big fan of, like, you know, vaporwave clothing, and you see the logo everywhere but don't really know what it is? Is this something that you were like, I don't even know if I want to use this. I'm OS 2 forever, you know, or Windows 3.11, you know, forever. Let me know in the comments down below. But this was like my first real love. This is really the operating system that got me started with computers and made me who I am today. In fact, one of my first websites had a Windows 95/98 tip of the day page. And the first Microsoft event I ever went to is when I was 14, and I made my mom drag me to a Windows 98 satellite launch event because I was very, very cool. Happy birthday to Windows 95 and probably the greatest software ad campaign of all time. Well, that does it for me. If you liked this episode, go ahead and give us a like. And on the YouTube, and while you're there, subscribe to Microsoft Developer for all of your nerd news needs. Also, let me know in the comments down below your thoughts on Windows 95, the Surface Duo, Visual Studio Code, anything else we didn't talk about. And I will see you next time.